Today, I have a very exciting episode for you all because, as the title suggests, it's about machine learning. But before we get into that, I'd like to quickly share my history with machine learning so far. Back when I was a kid, I've always had an interest with AI. I remember seeing the famous Carl Sims demo that procedurally generated genetic creatures using geometric shapes, say that 10 times fast, and then trained those creatures using a neural network. This was the first time that I ever heard about neural networks, and I was instantly hooked. But at the time, I barely started learning algebra in school, so understanding how to write one was way out of my league. Fast forward to 2015 and Google released TensorFlow, which is a very, very convenient machine learning library made by some very smart people. And 1 year later after that, there is a flood of super cool machine learning demos all over the internet. And that is when I found myself incredibly inspired to the point in which I knew I had to get my foot in the machine learning door. But here's the deal. At the point of wanting to get serious with machine learning, I didn't know calculus. I hardly knew anything beyond basic geometry, really. But I knew if I really wanted to try and make some cool machine learning projects, jumping straight into TensorFlow without knowing the material would have just meant all of my machine learning projects would have been the result of mastering the craft of copy and pasting code. But I didn't want to go out as no copy and paste master. I wanted to go out as guy who knows how to write neural networks and apply them in cool ways. So on March 17, 2017, I got serious and set out on a mission to learn how to write my own neural networks. And I can proudly say, 6 months later, I successfully trained my first neural network completely from scratch. It was a super basic neural network that was able to learn the order of the Super Saiyan stages, but it was a major prideful moment for myself. And today, it's finally time to start applying what I've learned and start writing some funky fresh machine learning projects. Okay, so where do we begin? There is so much to cover with this project, so buckle up everyone, but I promise it is going to be a lot of fun. Now, I think a good place to start would be to tackle why even use machine learning AI to begin with. So let's first build a simple game and start there. Here's how our game works. We have a little running bot named Forrest who just felt like running. Forrest automatically runs straight, but needs some help to turn left or right. You see, the only goal in this little robot life of his is to be able to run 2 complete laps on any course. Touching the walls means failure for Forrest. So with that said, as of right now, I have to help Forrest navigate the course using a joystick controller, or else he won't be able to run his desired 2 laps. But wait, there's a plot twist. I don't want to help Forrest navigate courses because I'm lazy. I really just want to sit on my little tush and eat candy all day. Why doesn't Forrest navigate the course his own damn self? Well, this is what happens when Forrest tries to do it on his own. So we need to teach him how to complete this course on his own using some sort of artificial intelligence. But before we add any AI, let's first take baby steps and give Forrest the ability to control this controller joystick. Now the joystick works like this. If the joystick is tilted all the way to the right, then the joystick will return a value of 1. If it's tilted all the way to the left, that's a value of -1. If centered, 0, and any percentage in between those 3 values is the percentage of that value. So halfway to the right is 0.5, halfway to the left is -0.5. Simple maths, you get it. But please do make a mental note that if I say tilt the joystick left to right, this is what I mean by it. Right on? Right on. So let's give this control over to Forrest, tell him to just randomly guess how to tilt the joystick for now, and let's see what he does. Absolute dunce. So. One simple AI we can give Forrest is some sort of pathfinding AI. We'd place a bunch of markers on the course and tell Forrest to tilt the joystick left or right depending on where the next marker is in relation to him. And 100% this will work, but it also comes with a few problems. 1, with this solution, he'll only become the master of this one course. And 2, I'll still have to do a lot of work placing these markers for every new course. And let me remind you guys, I am lazy. So, in complete surprise, we're actually going to add a neural network-based AI. Surprise! Neural networks are one of the best solutions for this problem because not only will Forrest be able to run the course on his own, but if we train him right, he'll also learn a general rule for all courses and be able to run laps around any course, even ones that he's never even been on, including this monstrous boss battle of a course here. But more on that later. Oh, okay, so just to make sure we're all still on the same page, here's where we're at. Forrest wants to be able to run 2 laps around any course, but currently only knows how to run forward. He needs help from me to navigate the courses for him using a joystick controller. I don't want to help Forrest because I'm lazy and my candy won't eat itself. And so far, we've given Forrest control of the joystick even though he has no understanding of courses. Speaking of which, how you doing over there, Forrest? Okay, let's get started on this neural network. Now, this is the part where everything starts to get a little gray area-y. Please keep in mind that neural networks is still an open research field, but I'm gonna do the best I can to make this all as intuitive as possible without getting all caught up in the maths and logic. So, let's get started. Actually, wait, I'm sorry. Before we can write our neural network, we need to first set up our inputs. Forrest has control of the joystick, but he has not even the slightest clue what to do with it. He has absolutely no understanding of the course at all, which is actually not only super interesting, but probably the most important thing to think about when it comes to neural networks. Why? Well, because every single part of your network depends on the quality of your inputs. Let's look at when I had control over the joystick. How did I have an understanding of the course? Well, using my eyes, I was able to send live data to my brain, which thankfully was smart enough to determine how far away the course walls were from Forrest, and then send that live data to my finger nerves or whatever so that I can use the joystick correctly. With the power of neural networks, we can give Forrest a brain and kind of sort of simulate this same exact brain process. Now, this is the neural network structure that I'm deciding to start with. 5 inputs, 4 hidden layer nodes, and 1 output. Instead of giving Forrest 2 eyes, or even 1 that can see actual images, we're instead going to take a more simplistic approach and give him 5 distances relative to his body as inputs, which are straight forward, left, right, and forward left. Forrest will then pass this data to the 4 hidden layer nodes, which each have 5 connections, 1 for each input. Each connection will have its own strength value, and each node will have its own bias that will help shift the... too technical. Just for now, know that the bias is very important for each hidden layer and output node. Now, with the hidden layer acting as Forrest's brain, his brain will do some calculations on the 5 inputs using its connection strength values and biases. Those calculations are then sent to the 1 output node, which again has its own bias and connection strength values connected to each of the hidden layer nodes. And finally, the output node will be able to calculate a guess for Forrest to either tilt the joystick left or right. I know it's a lot to follow, just bear with me. It gets better, I promise. And this entire neural network calculation will happen over and over and over again in real time, because Forrest's distance from the course will also change in real time. I hope I've explained this simply enough that you're still with me, because we are far from out of the woods. Forrest with his now new neural network brain doesn't mean that he's instantly, artificially, intelligent. Wow, what a tough audience. Hold on a second. Ah, yes. Basic_laughtrack3.wave. At least you always understand me. Anywho, Forrest is still far away from showing any signs of intelligence. You'll see that if we give him this brain with random values and watch what he does with the joystick, it's a little better, I guess. But still far from intelligent. You see, when writing neural networks, in most cases, it's broken down into 2 main parts. Designing the artificial structure, which is what we just did, and training the artificial structure, which is when the intelligence part comes into play. But, whoa. This has already been a lot of info to take in, and we've barely just got started with this project. So, I'm gonna be merciful and give you guys an intermission.